Tonight, in a 15-round international contest, world heavyweight champion Muhammad Ali defends his title against George Chavallo of Toronto, the Canadian heavyweight champion. This 15-round championship contest is coming to you direct from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. Greetings, everybody. No matter where you're watching, greetings from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. We have a tremendous crowd, estimated at up to 14,000 people, on hand for the heavyweight championship fight between Muhammad Ali and the Canadian champion, George Chavallo. And with this huge crowd in attendance, there's a feeling of excitement and anticipation as both fighters are now in the ring. They have just put their gloves on, and we're just about 2 minutes away from the bell for round one. And now, it's a great pleasure for me to introduce one of the outstanding figures in the world of sport. He's certainly no stranger to the television screen, the great fullback with the Cleveland Browns of the National Football League, Jim Brown.
Well, thank you, Hal. It's a pleasure working with you tonight, and it's also a pleasure to say hello to all of those folks out there, and especially the ones in Cleveland.
Jim, there's something about a heavyweight championship fight, isn't it? That feel about ringside that...
That's right, Hal. It's different than anything else that I've ever participated in. I'm not in the ring, but I'm as nervous as I can be. You know, it's something about it. I don't know what it is.
You have had the feeling, though, before many championship games. How do you feel just about 2 minutes before kickoff?
Well, you're scared to death, really. You're waiting for the ball to come, and when you get hit, it's all over. Then you're ready to play. Before the kickoff, it's really tough.
All right, Jim, let's switch our camera's attention to the ring now and get into position.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Some of the dignitaries in the ring with us at this moment.
You're cut off.
Working in George Chavallo's corner, ladies and gentlemen, the wonderful Brown Bomber, Joe Louis. Joe Louis. A man at ringside coloring the fight for the TV, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Football of the Cleveland Browns, Jimmy Brown. We have in the ring also former Canadian heavyweight champion from Toronto, Earl Walls. Earl Walls, ladies and gentlemen. Another former Canadian heavyweight champion from Montreal, Hall of Fame Bob Clarew. Bob Clarew. Here's the heavyweight champion of the wrestling world, ladies and gentlemen, from Edmonton, Alberta, Gene Kaminsky. Now, ladies and gentlemen, he brought this blockbuster, the one, the only, the great, Rocky Marciano. This is the main event of the evening. First in the white corner, from Louisville, Kentucky, weighing 214 and one-half pounds, wearing the white cross with the black stripes, Muhammad Ali. And now, in the red corner, from Toronto, weighing 216 pounds, wearing the black coat for the white face, George Chavallo.
They're both charged up. Make no mistake about that. The bell for round one. The champion wearing white trunks, scoring with a left and a right. Chevallo in black trunks. Left hook scored by Chevallo. Chevallo, of course, is expected to go to the body. Champion, that one connected, and a good jab. The champion has a certain type of jab. Some fighters will stick it. Chevallo will hammer to the body at every opportunity. He wants to wear down the legs of the champion. We're halfway through round one. Good left hook by the champion on Chevallo's face. The champ is connecting solidly with the left jab. To the end of round one. Play, of course, depends upon his great speed of hand and foot. Chevallo will try to get to the body at every opportunity. The crowd is solidly behind the hometown boy, George Chevallo, the Canadian champion. Both good jabbing punches. 30 seconds to the end of round one. It's the chance of a lifetime for Chevallo.
It looks like it's going to be a good one. The champ seems to be serious at times, and when he's serious, it looks like it's going to be a good fight. But of course, every once in a while, he likes to test himself, and he's playing a little bit.
Chevallo has never been knocked off his feet, and of course, has never been knocked out. You think the champ can do it to him?
I think he's going to have to do it. I think if it goes all the way, it could be a very tough fight for him.
That's Irv Ungerman in Chevallo's corner. The man in the center is Ted McWhorter, his trainer. And Whitey Bemstein is that white head that just flashes into your picture from time to time. 10 seconds to the beginning of round two. The champion is up on his feet, ready for action. And here comes Chevallo, round two. Chevallo is tough. Make no mistake about that. Shabalo weighed in at 216, 7 pounds more than expected. He said, it's my heaviest or my roughest and toughest fight. Shabalo hit him with a good left hook to the face in that exchange. About it. Chiarello, while he is not the Rocky Marciano type of puncher who can take you out with one shot, those punches to the body, would they wear you down over 4 or 5 rounds?
Well, actually, I don't think he's going to be able to do that for 4 or 5 rounds. I think Clay is going to have to move a little more after a few rounds, because if he takes those blows, it's got to wear him down somewhat. But if you notice, the blows are all on the side. There's nothing getting on the inside of him.
Clay was out early at the 10-second whistle. For now, he makes a face at the referee, and here they come for round three. The champ is determined now to display his boxing skills. Very fast with hands and feet, possibly the fastest heavyweight of all time in that department. He's scoring consistently with the left jab. Clay. Shabalo will just try to pull his way forward and get back to the body. But as Jim Brown pointed out, Clay is protecting the midsection while the blows are going to the side and back. Clay is completely unorthodox. He's liable to lead with a right or a left. You don't know what to expect. Good solid right to the midsection of play. Clay is completely unmarked from his fights. You'd never know he was a boxer. We're halfway through round three. He's a showman. He'll taunt you. There he led with the right jab. Blow. solidly with about three of those. A stunning left jab. That's rocking George. 10 seconds to go. Bell ending round three. Loretta Cassius is Clay's his corner there. Jim, how does he look to you at this point?
He looks like he's in better condition than I expect him to be, Hal, because he did bring training camp quite a few times before this fight came about. But he looks like he's ready to go for, 12 or 13 rounds.
I watched him, Jim. He came in here weighing 225, and he weighed in today at 214 and a half. He took the weight off rapidly, and in the gym, he looked as if he could go all night.
Of course, this could be telling, because when you take weight off that fast, it sort of weakens you. Of course, he doesn't look weak out there right now.
I think, too, if he does take his best shots at George Shimalo, whose corner we're watching now, and he doesn't put him away, it could be a discouraging factor for him.
That's very true, and I think that's the big question tonight. Can he actually knock this man out?
Clay is out of the ring, though the bell has just rung now. Here we go for round four. Shimalo has never been knocked off his feet. Never been knocked out. Backwards and forwards, but has great lateral movement in both directions. strong as a bull if he can corner him. Jab connecting solidly.
Takes the chances, I think that it'll be a great fight. But if he stands up and if he moves slow, it's just not going to be a good fight. But I think this round was a good one for him. If he keeps it up, if he keeps moving, if he has the stamina, he can put up a real good fight.
With about 30 or 40 seconds to go, he got in a smashing left hook, and the left connected solidly. I think it gave George, whom we can see here, a little bit of confidence, didn't it?
That's right. I hope he comes out in this round and continues that type of attack, because I think that's the only way that he is going to win this fight. It's his only chance.
The champion is standing, Angelo Dundee, his manager, giving him last-minute instructions.
All right. Take this distance.
Here we go with round six. There have been no knockdowns today. No knockdowns. Score the fight on the 5-point must system. The winner of a round must be given 5 points. The loser of a round, a lesser number. If a round is scored even, each fighter gets 5 points. go in the round. Well, there's the champ, Jim. How's he look at this point?
He looks a little tired at this point, Hal. I think he knows that it's going to take a lot of blows to knock Shivalo out. Shivalo keeps moving in, and this way I think the champ might become a little worried.
Seems to me that on the two occasions that the champ has switched to the uppercut, George Shivalo here was able to move in with good left hooks to the face and body. Those were the only two times in the fight that he really scored.
That's very true. He's ignoring the jab whenever he can get Clay on the ropes. And he's coming in and trying to get his blows in at that particular time. One thing that I can note, I think that Terrell has a stronger jab than the champ, because I saw these two fight before, and his jab kept Shivalo back a lot better.
Here we go with round seven. I imagine a lot of people didn't think Shivalo would be here for round seven, but he's here and still going strong. Dedication to his work just about now. Left hook, but he missed it. That left hook connected, but more in slap fashion than any kind of a blow. Push him out. 30 seconds left in round seven. Jab connecting solidly by the champion. Ten seconds to go in the round.
Yeah, all right, wait.
10 seconds to go to the start of the round. Clay is on his feet. Shivalo still resting. The bell for round eight. To a knockout.
Come on,
Round 8. The left hook just grazed his face, just missed. Play has never gone more than 12 rounds. To get in close, but failed to score. We're halfway through round 8. You can again see the mark on Chimelo's forehead high up near the hairline, but it certainly does not look serious. His left eye is beginning to swell, Chimelo's, and that's from the left jabs of the champion. 30 seconds left in round 8. Chimelo hit him with a good right hook to the body. Boy, right on your screen there now, there's not much doubt about who's the favorite, is there?
Oh, not at all. The action is good right now, Hal, but the question in my mind, and the question probably in the minds of all of our theater watchers, is does Clay actually have a knockout punch? And I think that's going to play a big part in this fight, because if he has to fight for 15 rounds, he's going to get awfully tired because he has to move. Chimelo is going to keep coming in the last few rounds. It might be very interesting.
There's one thing you can bet on with Chimelo. He won't quit. He's tough, strong, durable, and he'll go until he's exhausted. The champion up on his feet again as we get set for round 9. The ninth round. The champion scores consistently with the left jab. But Chavallo shows little sign that it bothers him that much. One minute to go in the round. Does not appear to be punching with as much authority as he was in earlier rounds. 30 seconds to go in the ninth round. Chavallo snorts with the right hook to the body and took a cover on the kick in exchange. Ten seconds to the end of the round. Get a look at George Chavallo. They're working on that left eye. That left eye doesn't look like a problem, does it, Jim?
No, it really doesn't look like a problem at this time. I think if Chavallo has the stamina, these last few rounds are going to be quite interesting because I know that Clay has to be somewhat tired at this particular point.
You know, Chavallo has always had the stamina, but this time he weighed in at 216, which is about 7 pounds above his ordinary fighting weight. That load may start to tell, too.
That's very true.
Here we go with round 10 coming up. There's the bell. Beneath this ring is a wooden floor. And beneath the wooden floor, the ice surface for the National Hockey League games, one of which takes place here tomorrow night. So they couldn't take the ice off. Is a left hook. As a 6 or 7 to 1 underdog. Halfway through round 10. A 3-inch edge in reach. Clay is 79 inches, Chavallo 76. The face of the champion. Is coming up. Clay is on his feet. Here comes Chavallo. Shimalo is trying to corner him and hammer away at the breadbasket. Shimalo has taken the champion's best shot without giving an inch. The left hook connected, but not as solidly as Shimalo would have liked. Neither fighter has been knocked down.
The way he should have, the way the champ opened up on him, and I think that can be very discouraging. This was a beautiful ending of the round for the champ because he had some good blows in there, some hard blows. Shimalo did not look like it it really affected him.
We're moving over here now to the champ corner. Maybe we can pick up a little sound. Let's try.
Number 12. Come on. I said number 12.
Come on, baby.
That was manager Angelo Dundee talking with the champ. There's the bell for round 12. The champion appears determined to open it up. The champion is unmarked. Shimano has some swelling around the left eye. But nothing to worry about. Halfway through round 12. To go. Round 12. Right hook landed on the champion's arm.
Little Mitchell, baby. 10 seconds
to go on the round. What do you look for in the last three rounds, Jim? You care to make a guess?
Well, actually, I think it's going to be to the champion's advantage to keep boxing, keep scoring, and probably forget about the knockout. Of course, I was hoping he would go for the knockout just to see if he did have that punch.
I think he has taken his best shots on occasion and found that George just didn't go down.
That's right. There have been two occasions that has happened.
That's Irv Ungerman, who's just facing the camera. The manager of George Shimano. Round 13 coming up. There's the bell. Shimano's up first this time. Round 13. Canelo knows if he could hit him that one deathly shot, he'd be seconds away from fame and fortune. The bell ending round 13. Jim, there was a lot of criticism about this match. And a lot of people were saying it never should have been held and that it was some sort of a social injustice being foisted upon the customers. They sound rather happy, don't they?
That's right. The fans seem to be very happy tonight, especially when Shivalo gets in a couple of good blows, and that he has done tonight.
The champion has now gone further than he has ever gone in his career before, 13 rounds. He looks fresh enough. He looks like he can go another two.
Oh, yes, he's definitely going to be able to go another two, Hal. But I think in his mind is the last Patterson fight, wherein he did not finish Patterson when people thought he could.
Round 14 coming up. Scheduled for 15 rounds.
He looks a little tired right now, Hal.
There's Joe Louis, who had his head up just the top head on the screen.
Well, he has a corner filled up with celebrities. Drew Bodini Brown, I think, is over there. He's not working with him, but he did work with him 2 weeks prior to the fight.
That's Pat McWhorter facing for the arm.
As you know, Hal, Brown worked with Floyd for many years.
McWhorter is exhorting the Canadian champion. to go out there and do it in the 15th round and try to build them out. This is it, the 15th round coming up. The scoring, as outlined by the Ontario Commissioner of Athletics, L.M. McKenzie, the five-point must system used in the scoring of points. The winner of a round must receive 5 points. The loser, a lesser number. If a round is scored even, each fighter is to receive 5 points. The scoring is decided by a majority decision of the referees and the two judges. So now, we await the count, the decision of referee Jackie Silvers and the judges Tony Canzano and Jackie Johnson.
There's the official decision, ladies and gentlemen. Referee Jackie Silvers scores Muhammad Ali 73, George Savalo 65. Judge Tony Canzano scores Muhammad Ali 74, George Savalo 63. Judge Jackie Johnson scores Muhammad Ali 74, George Savalo 63.